Shalom, and welcome to Bible Stories as Blueprints of the Soul, your Biblical Hebrew podcast. Shalom and welcome to our Biblical Hebrew conversation. What is the difference between a heart of stone and a heart of flesh? Why does a heart of flesh dependent or connected to the renewal of a new spirit within us? Let's look into the Hebrew terms in Ezekiel 36:26. The term in Hebrew for a heart of stone is lev even. Lev, heart, even, stone. Lev even. In those five letters, an interesting color is hiding. The letters from the word lev, heart, Lamed Bet, and the last letter from Evin, stone, is Nun. When we combine those two letters from the Hebrew word for heart, Lev, and the last letter from Evin, which is Nun, we are remaining with three letters, Lavan, Lavan. Lavan is white. In Hebrew, Lavan is also the name of Jacob's father-in-law, Laban. Usually the English Bible call him Laban, but in Hebrew it's Lavan. So what is a heart of stone? If we look into it, first of all we find the color of white, Lavan. Once we locate the word for Lavan, which is white, we give it numeral value. The numeral value of Lavan is 82. 4 Lamed is 30, Bet is 2, together is 32, plus Nun, which is 50, is 82. Now, the color of flesh in Hebrew, Basar, is red. The word for red in Hebrew is Adom, Adom. The stem letters are Adam, Adam, Aleph, Daled, Mem, Adam. The value of Adam is 45. Now, what is the distance between Lavan, which is the symbol of a heart of stone, and Adam, which is the symbol of heart of flesh? And the answer is 37. The distance between a heart of stone, Lavan, that its color is white like a stone, to the heart of flesh, which is represented by the letter of the word Adam, that its value is 45, the distance between those two numbers is 37, like the numeral value of Hevel, Hevel, in English Abel, Cain's twin, the shepherd, the first shepherd that was mute, that did not speak. He was silent like a lamb. So what does, in a way, Ezekiel wants to tell us? In this allegory, the new spirit could grant you with the ability to speak. A heart of stone is like a well of water. In the well, there is water. When people have access to the water, they can drink, and the herds can drink, the sheep, the goats, and other living creatures, of course, plants, and people can live around water. But if the well of the heart is blocked with a stone upon it, like we meet in the Bible when Jacob runs from his brother Esau. He ran to his uncle Laban, but on the way he finds a well, and many shepherds are gathering around the well because there is a huge stone on the well which blocks people and animals from drinking, from having life. So usually, according to the biblical story, many shepherds have together to roll the stone from the well because the stone is very heavy. So this is the daily happening in the Bible. This is the daily happening of the shepherds. But when Jacob sees Rachel next to the well, suddenly one human can do the work of many shepherds together. He can roll the stone from the well, and people and animals and everybody can live from the water. This is what Ezekiel tries to tell us. And please pay attention to all of those sub-connections that we do while we speak. Jacob is removing the stone from the well. Jacob also associated with the letter Vav, so to speak, the heart, the sphere of the heart, chakra, people might say, of the heart. And he has the ability to remove the stone from the well of the heart. And now, when there is no stone that blocks our heart, and then we have a heart of flesh, Adam, comes the speech of Abel. Abel is the one in us who thinks, but is not able to speak. But with removing the stone, the color white, the unmovable, the frozen of our heart, suddenly there is a space. The well of the heart has a space, nothing is blocking it any longer. And then the spirit can come and go, like the mikveh water, coming and going. While the spirit is coming and going, there is an ongoing conversation. And in this verse, we see many corrections are coming together. When Jacob corrects the silence of Abel, this is the first correction. When Jacob basically corrects also the silence and the passivity of Adam, whom did not speak when his wife gave him to eat from the tree of knowledge, he just ate with her without speaking. So, in a way, Jacob, by rolling the stone from the well, corrects Adam passivity, also corrects Abel incapability to speak. And while we speak, our mouth reveals the hidden thoughts of our mind. And the human mind is always being communicated by the infinite. And while we speak and share with the world the infinite communication of the source, we discover that there are no barriers and everything is one. So by removing the heart of stone, we do few things. We are correcting Adam passivity, Abel passivity, and we are initiating conversations.
Thank you for listening to Bible Stories as Blueprints of the Soul. We hope that you enjoyed this episode. If you have any questions, comments or would like to hear more about a certain topic, just write us an email to hebrew@learnoutlive.com. We are always happy to hear from you. For more episodes, videos, and articles like this, please visit our website at hebrew.learnoutlive.com. We also would like to invite you to join our live classes. Just search for Online College of Biblical Hebrew on Facebook and start learning now with students from all over the world. Kol Tuv and Shalom.